going home now. Hours of work. I'm gonna drive maybe 45 to 50 minutes. To Kildare. This is the basement car park here. Right. Go this way now. It's easy. It's closer. Okay. Here for vengeance. It's a nice evening. Tired of 12 hours work, busy today. Thank God it's nice. Nice going home when you're satisfied of your work. And patients will be happy. That's the main thing there. So I'm just leaving the hospital now, hitting the road. And this is Nutley Lane going to N11. So if you're happy to stay with me, then all right, we'll drive, go for a ride. I'm not going to point the camera towards me because it's dark, you can't see me. It's so slow in here, 30 kilometers per hour, and heading towards 60 kilometers in N11. it's very dry. It's 13 degrees Celsius. Whoa. Nice to hear that. Temperature is rising up. It smells summer now. But not yet. But anyway, weather is fine. Very dry. And it's a nice evening. And safe driving. Going home now. All right. So stay with me. It's gonna be like 45 to 50 minutes drive. But we just can't speed up this this road in here. It's just like 60 kilometers per hour speed limit. I don't want to take a chance. Garda might be around later as we hit in the M50. That would be nice. Always caught on a red light now. Well, anyway, it's 43 past 7. So I'm on my own. Janice is having her leave, and Kuya BJ's day off. Well, fuel will now rise us up to 148 per 1.48 euro per liter. So fast, so quick on a change of oil prices. But not that bad there in Kildare. So it's somewhat like 144, I guess. So my fuel is okay. So I'll just top up in Kildare. Anyway, we close late in there. This will be open up to 10, so that's fine. Lovely daffodils on my right, guys. Have you seen that? The yellow one? Those are daffodils. So this kind of flower just spring up, grow in springtime. Nice to see that. I can see the moon on my right. That would be nice. So the moon will be lighting up my way back home. So safety for all motorists, I pray. Bring us home safe to our family. So drive safe. Turn right here now. Oh, loads of daffodils in there now. You can see. I turn right. This is heading towards exit to going to M50. The light traffic now, very light, especially at this hour. It's so quiet now. Slide left here. Heading towards exit 14 on the M50. So this is where I came in this morning. And I'm just using the same road. Going back, Avonmore. It's a milk brand, it's nice. So this is heading to M50 North. Northbound. And then the exit there towards northbound M50. Speed limit is 100 kilometers per hour. Now this area, although this motorway, it's still busy, so we have the speed limit of 100. Although we're allowed to run as much as 120 kilometers per hour on a motorway. But they're putting at the speed limit here at 100. Because this area is still busy. So this is life on a fast lane again. Road is clear. It's a light traffic. It's not even moderate, especially at this hour. It's getting cooler now at 12 degrees Celsius. And it's nearly 8 o'clock now. It's 53 past 7 in the evening. This is your friend, Benito Maligon. Please watch me on my YouTube channel, Benito Maligon Official. I have loads of adventures in there, including fishing, walking, some trips, driving. Cooking, fishing, what else? Just part of life, guys, no? The basic. So I just love what I'm doing. So just do what you love doing, and that's it. That's life. Motorways are usually six lanes, so three on the left and three on the right. And we are separated by barrier. You have to find exits to turn around. You cannot just do U-turns in there if you are in M50. Separate by barriers in there, so you can't just jump and carry your car and turn around. So I'm heading towards exit 12 now, and I'm looking forward to that exit 9. I remember on my video that I was lost in there. I get passed through exit 9, so I have to find my way out. And I stop my video because I have to use the phone for the Google map. It was funny. A funny experience. I can see the lights in there, it's very nice. going to have that video on the end there, nearly towards home, where the road is very dark. Let's see if the camera can capture anything in there. Oh, this is N11. Exit 11. So we have two more exits, and that's it. And we're going to. We're going towards N7, and then straight to that is the motorway 7. This is motorway 50. I don't know what's the significance of that number in there. Why 50? Why 7? A loads in there of motorways here. M8, M9. So there's expanding road networks to connect this huge place. But not as big as Mindanao. Mindanao is bigger than this island is. Mindanao is huge. I can drive from south to north in just a day. Why was that? Okay, this is exit 10. Then transfer now, change lanes to the left. Heading towards exit 9 for 1 kilometer now. And slide to the left again to exit 9. So we're heading towards N7. So we have three national roads in there, N7, N8 and N9. I like that kind of lights on top in there. It's very bright, it's very nice. The road is clear. Safe driving. Now as you merge in here, 60 kilometers there per hour. Make it safe. So this is where this road usually where the guard is. There's loads of cars. It's on the side of the road with their guns on it, looking for some speeding cars. That's why it's limited only for 100 kilometers an hour. Not bad. Change lane there. There's one behind, running fast. Okay, guys. It's a nice day, nice work today. Not too bad. Bit busy. But the patients are satisfied to say thank you. That's all what matters. Staffing is not bad today. Phone services. We have two entrances. And we have three cares. Time check is 8:02. So we hope to be there by 8:45. At 12 degrees Celsius. I'm not even heating up the car, guys. I didn't switch it on the heating. It's warm a little bit inside now. It's too warm down there in the hospital in the room. So we have to open up the windows there for some cool air. Tired today, yes. Take my dinner when I arrive home. Please God. And go to bed early. I still be working tomorrow. Same time. Speed up a bit now. Still three lanes on this national road. Oh, I'm in six lanes, yeah. Three on the left and three on the right. And that is heading towards Rathcoole there, and exit there on my left. A few cars on the road heading home as well. Oh, why did I change the lane there? There's a big truck there running low, slow. I'm speeding on my right, still okay. There. One speeding up behind me. Go ahead. Oh, it's a lady. Well, I know, yeah. That's why insurances for the ladies are a bit higher than the men. To be honest, because ladies are really, really like fast drivers, to be honest. There's road work going on. Okay, change here now. Oh, it's only one lane. Two lanes are closed. Okay. So stay here now. Let's slide to the left. Going on there. right. Oh, big light there. So we usually do the works at night, guys. So not to put the traffic on hold on the days, you know, where it is much busy. You don't want to disturb the motorist on the daytime. That's very nice system. Have the plans ahead. Not to disrupt the traffic during the day. So we're still on N7 at exit 5 in there. Yes, I go farther, guys. There's lesser and lesser cars, you know. There's one at a time they're exiting here now. It's getting colder now, 11 degrees Celsius at 8 past 8 in the evening. This is your friend Ben. Slow down a bit. No police cars there. Now, sometimes they blink the lights in the car, but sometimes they're just hiding there on the side road, looking for motorists or speeding. Not bad, running at 100 kilometers per hour now, heading towards Kiltil. At exit 6 now. And here we go on the left, yeah. Very nice and cool evening, driving down the road. Driving the fast lane. Oh, not really. Not so fast. I'm hitting now 108 kilometers per hour now. Reduce a little bit. Exit 7 is Straffan on N7. I remember before a friend of mine just bring me here to buy some fish or seafoods, but it's all like frozen one. You can buy meat in there by boxes. Big prawns. I call everything in there like shrimps, but call it prawns here, the big ones. Next exit is exit 8, Hill. What a word. But it's not an English word, guys. I mean, like, it is an Irish word, a Gaelic one. So sometimes get mixed up with this word, those words. Well, I think it's English one. I don't know where they got the name. I don't know why they name it Kill. That's exit 8 here now. And then I'm heading towards Johnstown. So at the end of N7, guys, it's just a road straight towards M7. But this is a new road, a new development, that's why we don't have that much street lights. But we have the what do you call it, lights on the road in there. The what do you call this one? I forgot it now. My mind is not working. This is now heading towards M7. As you can see, street lights with the post in there is not visible after this post. There. This is what I'm saying to you. It's a new development, but they don't have the side. The roadside post with lights in there. But we are still guided though with this what you call it, the one on the road. I forgot it now, honestly. So it's a bit dark, yeah? It's only the headlight there of the car that is visible, and the taillights of the cars in front of me. But I can use the fog lamp, but I will do that later. Still a bit busy, a few cars ahead of me, a few cars behind me, not bad. There in front of me, about 200 meters. A few cars as well, and big trucks on the other side of the road. To my left, that's going to Newbridge, exit 10. So we are heading towards exit 14. That's where we are looking for. So the next exit is Newbridge, exit 10, that's a road 445. I'm still not familiar with all the exits in here, guys. A few times try to drive down here though, on those exits. But you don't worry, because you have your GPS though. If you have your phone, you can use the Google Maps there. I used to have the sat nav before, but crazy, to be honest. I bought it €100, but I didn't use it. Not until I had the phone, and then download Google Maps. And it's hundreds easy, guys, because the updates, it's all with Google. So it's handy, easier for us to travel. Just in case if you're not familiar with the place you're going to, you know. So there are no street lights on this part of M7 heading towards Kildare. There's few one on the exits, especially for those areas who has the overpass. So we usually have some lights on top in there. This one now, there's an overpass there, there's no lights. You have those reflectorized thing then on the road that will guide you. Reflectorized paint and reflectorized what material is that? Once your headlamp will hit that, it will just reflect and it will give you guide. Especially when it's raining. Or when it is foggy. So this is exit M9 there on the left hand side. Yeah, that's exit 11, that's heading towards motorway 9. There's a horse trailer there. Yeah, that's a horse in there inside. Transport. Oh, it's a fuel. fuel. There's a few cars behind me again. Moving fast, change lane. Now this is what I'm talking about, guys. There's a few big lights there. This is exit 12, the Clara. It's military comp on this area, guys, so you're not allowed to fly your drones. Near on this military camp. So they call this place the Quora. So we have two more exits. Heading toward exit 13 now. Houses in here, guys, though, but it's not on not on this side of the road. It's four-lane road now. Running 110 now, not too bad. Just take it easy. Down in Monasterevin. I'll still be working tomorrow. It's usually a busy night here now. I usually don't have any cars on my sides or in front of me at this hour. Wave of Jesus Christ. Italy is having their lockdown as well. And Philippines is locked down as well for foreigners to come in. Too bad. It's not easy for us. Oh, honestly, I'm done of everything. Like, but somewhere down the road, I know the road away. Down the road. It doesn't really matter where, but somewhere down the road. What is somewhere down the road? There's a big slogan there, tiredness kills. Drivers here are being monitored on their trips if they are taking some rest, just to make sure they are safe and not traveling. So if you feel tired, pull out, have some rest before you go ahead. Exit now on 14 towards Monastir Revan. It's a part of Kildare. Alright guys, I'm going to take a call now from my wife.